Well, as an early teenager, my next guest had the choice of horsepower, that is a mechanic, or follow the family business and take up standard bed training and driving. Thankfully for harness racing, he chose the latter. I'm joined by Jack Law, who in the space of 6 years has made a very successful career already. Well, Jack, good to catch up with you. Those early choices of being a mechanic or being involved in harness racing, how close were you to staying with your first choice?
Pretty close. So towards the end of year 12, I got offered an apprenticeship to be a diesel mechanic, but I just started driving at the trials, and if I started driving at the trials a couple of months later, I'd probably gone down that path. But yeah, it was a little bit too late. I'd sort of got stuck into the horses, and whether it was a good decision or not, I don't know, but I've had a little bit of success so far, so it's worked out okay.
We'll have a look at that shortly, Jack, but you were born into harness racing, your father, of course, being Michael, and your mum, Tony, harness racing on her side of the family as well?
Yeah, that's it. Her dad, or my pop, David Mace, has always been heavily involved in the trots and, sort of done it his whole life. And he was the clerk of the course back home until he was about 75 or something ridiculous like that. So he has the horses running through his veins, and pass it on to mum, and I've got it now. And dad also had a little bit on his side too with his dad. He was involved with the horses a bit too, but bred into it. Yeah.
And Jack, of course, your father's had a very successful career back in Tasmania.
That's it. He's trained horses for a fair while over there, and trained a few winners, so he's had a pretty successful career as a trainer. And he worked for a couple of good trainers when he was a kid, and so he learnt the ropes off guys like Vinnie Knight and the like. So he knows his stuff, and probably to this day he's probably one of the better trainers that I've sort of worked with. I'm probably a little bit biased because he is my dad, but as far as attention to detail and things like that go, he's probably up there.
Jack, it was before your time, but working with Finn Knight would have been a wonderful experience on so many levels.
Yeah, just about any question I'll ask him, he can give me an answer and sort of refer back to something that he learnt when he was there. So he didn't spend a lot of time, like a long time there, but the time that he did spend there, he learned a lot. So, no doubt that would have helped him.
And he would have had a good time too with the late, great Vinnie Knight. Now, some stern words by your mother was the catalyst from really getting you involved into harness racing.
Yeah, that's it. Told me to get off my ass and go and pick up the yards and do the waters and that, and school on the school holidays. And So I wasn't really that interested in them, as you said earlier, and sort of got out there that school holidays, and just sort of kept going out and helping then after that. But stern words probably helped.
Jack, what was the decision to move to Victoria? How did that all come about? You're only going to go there for a year for a learning experience?
I went over to Victoria with my dad because every now and then he likes to take a little team over for a while when Tassie cuts back to sort of one meeting a week. He would go to Victoria, so I went over with him for a little while, and when I went back, I sort of thought I wouldn't mind just going over and working for someone for a little while. And I did, went and worked for Andy and Kate Gath for about the 12 months that I was supposed to be there, and they were really good. They're great to work for, good people. And then I spent a little bit of time with Gavin Lang, nearly 12 months again with him. John Nicholson worked up to Bendigo after that, and gave Glenn and Julie and Eric a hand. So I've sort of been pretty lucky. I've helped out with a few good trainers since I've moved over, and that's probably a part of why I sort of didn't move back, because all those guys sort of got me on a bit of a roll, to a point where it was, yeah, more viable for me to stay in Victoria.
Hey Jake, the fact that you were working with Glenn and Julie Douglas, a wonderful experience as far as they're concerned, but also the fact that you're driving for a wonderful owner in Eric Anderson, who's put in so much money over so many years, and it's always good to see him have a nice horse.
Yeah, correct. Yeah, he does put a lot of money into the game. So, yeah, you got that right. Yeah, he's been very good to me. I've driven for Eric and those guys for a fair while now. He actually probably was one of the first people to give me a drive when I moved over to Victoria. So I don't know how long ago that was, for 5 or 6 years. And yeah, he's probably one of the first people to actually give me a go. So I didn't drive for him a lot when I first started, just got a few claiming drives. And yeah, after COVID and that, I probably started driving for him a little bit more. And they've been pretty good supporters for me the whole way.
Yeah, it's good to see Eric here tonight. Jack, now you had some success at Geelong last night for the Douglas Stable, winning double, of course, for Eric. You're having a very good season. You're at the top of the state and metropolitan table at the moment. You've got people like Chris Alford, James Herbison, and Greg Sugars nipping at your heels. That's not a bad trio.
Oh, yeah. It's only the start of it's a long 12 months racing every day back home. So, it's only the start of the year, so we won't get too far ahead of ourselves. But there's some quality drivers back home. So, I suppose it's a little feather in your cap if you can start off sort of level with those guys, yeah.
Are you also training a small team of horses under your dad's name?
Yeah, there's 8 at home at the moment. I'll give a shout out to Roma at Roma Pocock's old stables there and across the road from the Bendigo racetrack. So she's another one that's been a big supporter of mine. So the horses are there. There's about 8 of them there, and work those. We've got Liam Mulder sort of working for me, and my partner Ellen, she's working 12. So between us, there's about 20 horses there. And, chipping away at them and then going off to the races after that.
Apart from those people you've already mentioned as being influential as far as your career is concerned, also you have the utmost respect for the Rattray family.
Yeah, those guys are a massive name in Tasmania, but everyone's heard of them. You know, wherever you go, everyone knows a Rattray, and obviously you've got James up here. Back home they're massive family in the sport, and they've got generations of success and things back home. Yeah.
Jack, back in July 2022, you'd already driven 5 winners at Mildura twice, but you went a couple better, 7 winners on the Mildura card, just falling one short of joining Mark Pitt, who drove 8.
One of those nights, had a bit of luck. And I was telling you before, Albie Ashford got tipped out early on in the night, so he couldn't drive one of his own, and it was one of them winners as well. So it was unlucky for him, but just picked up a couple after that, and it was handy. I was driving a couple for Eric, so that whenever he goes up, they're usually pretty competitive. So It was just one of those good nights where sort of everything fell into place.
Jack, being able to pick up a drive and drive for other trainers as well, so there was numerous trainers involved in this outstanding contribution that you... that adds further merit to the fact that you were able to drive so many winners, driving for so many trainers.
I've got the photo on the wall at home, actually, so I should be able to tell you who I drove for, but there might have been, 3 or 4 trainers involved with those horses. So it's a funny little track, Mildura, and funny horses going around there. So you need the horsepower around that track as well. So as I said, just everything fell into place.
Captain Belisario would be one of your favorite horses. He provides you with one of your 2 Group 1 wins.
Yeah, he's probably one of the most talented horses that I've driven. He's a little bit of an enigma, sort of, at this stage. I think he's back having a spell again now. So, as far as ability goes, he's right up there with, one of probably the best horses that I've driven. And, if he can ever come back and put a strong, consistent prep in. He could go a long way, that horse, but yeah, he's just always had these little things go wrong with him along the way. But him and Torrid Sane are probably out there with the two best ones that I've driven. There's not really a lot between them when they're both at their best, but I think he's off in America now, Torrid Sane, and so we're looking for the next one to fill his shoes.
Jack, you just had your first Menangle experience. How'd you find it with Alvis and Kango? A very good effort in front, running third to Brooklyn Bridge.
Yeah, no, he went good. It's a funny track. I knew it would be anyway, but yeah, it's a very fast track. So anyway, it was good to get a guide how the first one sort of stood up. And he ran a good race, so hopefully the next two go all right too.
Jack, when you're going to have your first drive here at Club Menangle, being a young participant, do you study how the races are run here at Club Menangle, or do you seek any advice?
We watch the trots every Saturday night when we're sitting back at Melton watching Menangle. So it's very incredibly different racing pattern up here as it is back home. It's probably a lot more tactically tempo related in Victoria. The smaller track probably plays that way, whereas here it seems to be the first horse that makes a move is, you know, often the first one beat. So it's a lot more sort of American style racing on this big track, but you can see why once you go out there and have a spin around it, just how fast the horses are going. You know, it's incredibly hard out there off the track. So I guess, you know, you're always watching back home, and yeah, you realise that before you come up here, yeah, just how different it is.
Well, Jack, it's been good to catch up with you. It's been an outstanding start to the career over the past 6 years, and hopefully it will continue.
Yeah, no, hopefully so. Thanks.